Hello guys and welcome to TechWolf. In this video we will talk about DJI Osmo Action Camera. Before we start talking about this, guys, I decided to talk to you a little bit. First thing what I wanted to talk about is giveaways. In this video, like I promised in my last video, I will be giving away DJI Osmo Action Camera. So if you are interested, guys, all you need to do is leave a comment. You have to be subscribed to my channel, guys, and you have to sign up for the website, which I'm leaving in the first comment of this video. What I wanted to talk about is all my draws on this channel are real. Last DJI Osmo Action Camera I also sent to the guy, and if you are watching this, you can also confirm this in comments area. So as on that website where you have to sign up, guys, I'm also will be publishing all people who will be winning draws or who will be winning these prizes from me. So this is for proof for all of you, or for future, or for governments, or for anyone who will ever claim that I haven't been doing these giveaways and I haven't been actually giving them away, guys, because for me it is just fun, guys. In real life it is for me fun, and I'm not losing much by giving away you these cameras or giving away every month like $100. And that's what I wanted to talk about, that in my channel, guys, everything is real. There is no fake giveaways, there is no fake cameras, there is no fake and by the way, guys, there is iPad Pro as well, which you can still join. There is the video, I will leave the video and link as well. If you are interested, just leave your comment under that video, as I will be doing this iPad Pro giveaway as well by the end of this month. If there will not be 250 comments, as I was claiming that I need 250 comments in that video. So if you are interested to join that giveaway, also leave a comment under that video and you are also in a draw for iPad Pro if you are interested to win. So as in this video, guys, I am giving away DJI Osmo Action Camera. And now let's go and I will show you the best DJI Osmo Action Camera settings. Let's get into settings, and here is how camera looks. Like I mentioned, guys, I will show you the best settings to be able to film in any situation, whether it's evening or whether it's a daytime. So first thing to switch on this camera, let's go over the all settings in this camera. To switch it on, you click here this button on the left hand side, guys, and camera will turn on. To get to settings, you just swipe from up to down and you will see here different settings, and first one is profile. You can set up different profiles here and you can change them after if you want, and we will set up one profile as well in this video, and you can delete profiles as well. So let's go back, and here is brightness of the screen, guys. You can switch on brightness, or you can make this brightness is only for screen, if you want to make it brighter or if you want to make it darker. And then you can lock screen by third one. If you click on this one, you see that screen has been locked, and now if you hover the screen or tap the screen, it is not responding. To unlock the screen, you just swipe it back up, and let's swipe back down, and here are general settings. First one is voice control, and this means that you can switch on voice control if you want control this video by voice, but you can also, voice control is also available on the main screen here at the bottom if you would want, for example, to switch it on or off. In my case, voice control is off currently. If I would switch it on, for example, now as you see voice control is on, I say start recording, it starts recording. If I say stop recording, it stops recording, guys. I am always disabling this recording myself. And then we have front screen, and if we would want to switch to front screen, all we have to do is click this side button and hold it for 3 seconds. Now I'm seeing my front screen. There are black stripes on top on the and on the bottom of this, and this is only because of reason, guys, that I am seeing how video will look in 16:9 format. And if you would want, for example, to be it full screen, then again, let's hold it on the side for 3 seconds. It switches on back screen. You swipe down settings and you need to click on this last one icon and full front screen on now. And if we would now, for example, do exactly the same, if we would hold for 3 seconds, we go back and we see the full screen. But I prefer that mode, which shows me black stripes, because then I'm seeing exactly how video looks in real life and
what is included in video. Let's go back. More settings, like I said, are available under here. If you click on settings on that third icon, which is on top row, there is voice control settings, there is snapshot, there is quick switch, quick switch applies that you can activate with quick switch whatever you want, and quick switch, like I mentioned, is here on the right hand side. You can adapt that button to some other functionality if you would want to. Then you have your wireless settings, for example, for your internet connection when you are connecting your camera to your smartphone. Then you have wind noise reduction, and that always for me is on, guys. And sounds, I am removing sounds. This means that if you are switching on or off this camera, it starts recording, it doesn't create any beeps. Face oriented exposure, guys, that is on. And grid, I am switching off always. You can also add grid to these screens, but I don't want this grid because screen is small already. Auto flicker is on, let it do its job, and it is doing a rather good job. Screen auto sleep, I put it never, because when I am recording, and if screen auto sleep is on, for example, for 5 minutes, if we go in here, it will switch on the screen while you are even recording. That's why I put it off. The recording screen off, and auto power off is on 15 minutes. If I would be able to, I would put it to never, the auto power of this camera, because I like when this camera is on all the time unless I switch it off. I also do it with my other devices like smartphone, for example. And LED, this is all off. This means that there are red lights which you can see while you are recording. I have switched them off to not attract attention if I'm switching in some public place and those lights are on, so other people don't see that I am filming. This means that my LEDs are off and my sounds are off as well, so nobody knows when I start filming and nobody knows when I stop filming. So as nobody sees if I'm filming, if my LED lights are off, there is no red light on while I am filming, guys. And you can change your language, and there are different other settings which you can see here. You can reset to factory settings, guys. And about, you can see information about which version software update is installed on your DJI Osmo Action Camera. Let's go back now out and let's swipe it up. And if you swipe it up once more, you will see the resolution in which you are filming. Here I am filming normally in 1080p. To in 30 frames per second, because that's how I am editing my videos. And if you are filming, for example, in 4K, sometimes I'm filming also in 4K, then you will need a bigger computing power to edit your videos. And that's exactly the reason why I'm filming in 1080p and 30 frames per second most of the time. And Rocksteady is always on. And there are a couple of modes where Rocksteady, if it is not blue, if you will be, for example, scrolling this, and Rocksteady will switch off at 720p, 240 frames per second, Rocksteady will be off. So I am always using 1080p and 30 frames per second, and 30 frames exactly because of reasons that this is for more cinematic filming. If you would be doing like slow-mo after and so on and so forth, then you would want higher frame rate on your camera. So once you have set your resolution, let's go back out, and this is by sliding down now, and here on the right hand side you slide and you will see ISO settings. And ISO settings also always leave on auto. If you will be adjusting manual ISO settings, you will need to adjust them to light whenever you are filming in different situations, because if there is a dark, you will need to adjust them to dark filming. And if you will be filming, or for example, in daylight, you will need to adjust them for filming in daylight. If you will be filming in different lamps or lights, guys, you will also need to adjust your ISO settings. But if you don't know Calvin Klein's how lightning is measured or light is measured, guys, you will not know how to use them. However, you can study a little bit about lights, about ISO settings, and then you can adjust them for situation in which you are filming. But me, for filming and to be able to film in any situation and just take camera out, whether it's evening, whether it's day, guys, I'm leaving them to auto. Here is another, as you can see, video icon. If you click on that, here at the very bottom you will see DVRAP. I always put it on, guys. If your DVRAP is on, this means that you will not have a fisheye effect on while you will be filming. And now let's go back and let's save this profile. After you have done, guys, you just slide this back in, and then you can slide from the top to the bottom, and here click on this profile first icon. If you want to save, click on this profile and you say OK. And this profile has been saved.